rock and rumble.
That's a new one on me.
Oh, come on. Veggie, like you eat lots of veggies.
Now, wouldn't that be slang? Come on.
Common usage.
I'll check it.
I wish Robin could have been here tonight.
Time to cram for a chemistry test. She always waits the last minute to get together with a bunch of girls to study.
Vegetables. No veggie.
We all use it, don't we, Grandma?
We agreed if it's not in Webster's Collegiate, no points.
Yeah, it's an old dictionary.
It'll be in the new edition.
Well, then it should count, right, Pop?
Not according to your rules.
Try again, sport.
You have to leave so early?
It was a wonderful dinner, Carol. Thanks. Your first night here, and we put you to work.
Just try keeping her out of the kitchen for the next 2 weeks.
You're going to spoil us rotten.
Wow. What are grandparents for?
I don't see Pop complaining too much.
I'll see you in the morning.
What time are you usually at home?
It varies. Please, don't plan your schedules around me.
Figure between 6:30 and 7.
Oh, that must be so hard.
I've adapted.
Now, I was thinking about the children.
We've adapted.
Well, I think those hours are outrageous.
Bye, Pop.
Good night, kiddo.
I'll walk you to the car.
Sure, Frank. Thanks.
Good night, everyone.
So, is it still my turn?
Yeah, gotta do better than veggie.
I left the number where you can reach Robin by the phone in the kitchen.
I saw it. Now, don't worry. We'll see both of them get to bed on time.
Yeah, you're a better man than I am, Gunga Din.
It's good to be with them again.
Sorry it's been so long.
No. That was our fault. We always knew the door was open. It's just that we loved our Susan so much. We were afraid of the memories in this house.
You made this house possible, Frank. You designed it, decorated it, practically built it with your own hands, and paid for it inside and out.
That was your wedding present. Now, what else would an architect give his favorite daughter?
Still, it was a hell of a surprise. On a cop's salary, I was expecting to live in an apartment for a few years.
There's nothing we wouldn't do for you and the kids, Wes, then or now. Just seeing them brings back all the happiness we know Susan had in her life with you.
She's always with us, Frank.
Take care of yourself out there.
Officer needs help. Handle the
Branscombe.
No way, Jose.
We kill you, man.
No, I don't think that's gonna happen. You should be smart and let this one go.
This is 16th Street Turf. We rule here.
This boy's from Factory Town. They rule one block away. You've beaten him up enough, Jose.
No, Jose. Yo soy Luis.
Step aside, Luis.
He's mine. Pig.
Not unless you want to cut through me first, hombrecillo. Let's go, move it!
Halt, police!
Thank you.
No, I'm okay. I'm perfectly fine.
We'll get you a job as a stunt man.
You don't wind up in the morgue first.
How can we cop that? No, no, he's immortal. Don't believe in it.
Well, I'll read his file.
Give him his present. Come on, let's
okay,
go.
Okay, okay. All right, let's do it.
Amazing, no question about it.
Oh, I haven't even been gone 72 hours.
Yeah, but you were under observation. You had a CAT scan.
If something bounced off my head, Kevin will tell you, that couldn't have possibly hurt me, right?
Super cop.
And no concussion?
No. No concussion, just a couple of bruises and a strained leg muscle. They're going to check me again in 2 weeks.
Amazing.
Robin, still at volleyball practice?
Yeah. I'm going to pick her up in half an hour.
Oh, thanks, Frank.
Hey, Pop, watch this.
Do you guys go crazy?
Well, look, it's a bed.
Yeah, we rented it at medical supply house.
So you won't have to walk up the steps.
Oh, that won't be necessary. I can do everything but dance.
Challenge you to the high hurdles.
I appreciate the thought, Carol, but actually I'm planning on showing up for work tonight.
Well, don't be silly, Wes. For the rest of the week, you're going to be my patient, and I'm looking forward to it.
I really can't.
Of course you can. Even the police department allows a few days sick leave now and then.
Yeah, Pop's been saving his for 10 years now.
The fact is, we're always shorthanded down at the HD. Someone took over my workload, and the backlog of unsolved cases does get longer and longer.
He won't change his mind.
Well, your father has a sense of duty. We have to respect that. Would you excuse me? I'm going to check on the roast. You will be here for dinner.
Of course.
Give me a hand, would you, Frank?
Well, Pop, you'll never get a job in public relations.
Or family relations either, huh?
Some guys will do anything to get out of work.
Work? I don't see much work going on around here.
And I tell you, that stripper was the right medicine to get him up.
Stripper? What stripper?
Let's go, Kennedy.
Slow down for Quasimodo.
See you later, Speedy.
I don't need a lecture on why I can't go back on duty.
That comes later. Wes Kennedy wanted to take it. He's in charge of the gang task force.
My job is to do anything possible to keep the peace among the gangs. When is that possible? Understand, most of the people that live on these streets have nothing to do with the gangs and want nothing to do with the gangs.
I don't envy you the job.
Right now, you're the man in the middle. That's why we must talk. Rosa Santiago. You recognize her?
That's not someone you usually forget.
Can I hear the end of the tape again?
I will name the time and place of any meeting, Captain Ortega. There will be a war with the factory town gang, an open war with the police, unless you bring me the detective who killed Luis.
La Rosa Negra, the Black Rose. She is now the leader of the 16th Street gang.
A woman?
A girl, the leader of a major gang? You helped their succession when you killed Luis. She was waiting in the wings?
No.
Not exactly. Her family started the gang years ago. To keep up with her brother, she would make the hits. Being a woman, she could get in and out of places real easy. Last count, she may have done 7 murders.
What a horror story.
And yet you're part of it. You saw the 16th Street gang leader, Luis, gun down the boy from the factory town gang.
And encouraged by Rosa Santiago.
Now, by the street code, the factory town gang must make an attack.
The fact that I shot Luis should have evened up the score.
In a gang war with the police, that doesn't mean anything.
Then why her conditions that I be there?
By the rules, that account must also be settled.
Why do I think it's even more personal?
You've got good instincts, Kennedy. Luis was Rosa's lover.
You're still holding out on me.
It may be to my advantage to have her attention focused on personal vengeance.
I heard her conditions. If I can help prevent a gang war, I'll go.
I'm talking about putting your life in danger. You understand the risks? Because if you'd known, now is the time to back out.
Rosa's personal selection. This is Officer Kennedy.
Sí, lo recuerdo. Yo hablaré con él a solas. Vuelva hacia el carro.
She wants Yo to talk. Comprendo.
Hablemos en español.
Hablemos en inglés.
Senor, you think I can end gang wars?
You can try to end this one.
Machismo. There's nothing else. Debts must be paid.
Doesn't have to be that way. Why can't it change?
You feel the pain, don't you? Just as I feel it. Something I love has been taken from me.
Isn't it possible I could understand?
Luis is dead. How would you know about someone who was dead?
My wife was killed. She died in the streets with guns and violence. I do know, Rosa.
You want forgiveness? Go see a priest.
Forgiveness? La Rosa Negra, you are much more than a little girl. What I ask is even more difficult than forgiveness.
Why should I give you anything?
No one remembers how these barrio wars started. Yet they will continue unless someone says enough, no more killing.
Senor, there is one thing I have learned about men. Just as you, they all want something from me. They believe they can own me. But in truth, they are mine.
I'm not asking anything from you for myself. Just answer why more young men must die.
Luis is dead. You took his life. Now you have become mine.
You can put an end to it, Rosa. You have that power.
It will end. I see you suffer. I see you feel the pain and hatred I have suffered.
I take back what I said. You're still a child. A very little child. Who wants to get even with the world because she can't have her own way.
You will curse the first moment you saw me. I will kill you, Senor Kennedy.
Down the other night, you saw it with your own eyes.
That's exactly why I want to transfer to the gang task force.
You're the last person I'll tell you what to
do. Ask him.
Look, the gang is going to dog you. They'll be on your tail wherever you go.
They have a war on their hands down there, Ed. I'm Rosa Santiago's personal vendetta.
That's not the way Ortega sees it, believe me, Kennedy. He knows what's going on. He reads gang attitudes better than you ever will. If he wants you out of there, you stay out of there.
He needs manpower.
For your own safety, Ortega recommends that you either go on inactive service because of your injury or you use some of your vacation time.
Pappy.
You had your shot with Ortega. That's it, over and out.
I'm not going on inactive service.
Then you finish your shift and you take the vacation.
I stumbled into this helping a fellow officer. What would you do?
You're an over your head on this one, Wes. Listen to the man. You're no good to anybody dead.
Thank you.
What it is too easy. You have not yet felt the pain.
Everything all right?
Driving those two kids to school is a new experience every day.
Certainly lets you know what they're thinking.
Even if you don't want to know.
I just love them. You should be very proud.
I am.
Would you like some more coffee?
Yes, thanks.
Something's bothering you, isn't it?
Oh, I'm just a little tired this morning.
Does this have anything to do with it? Automatic telephone tape, isn't it? Recording device. Must have made the attachment while we were at school.
We have an alarm system throughout the house against break-in. I just thought this would be an extra precaution.
Against what?
Oh, I don't want to alarm anyone, but occasionally in my job, like a judge or a lawyer, people make threats. But they rarely carry them out.
That sounds a lot more serious than you're admitting.
It's happened before.
At breakfast, you were suggesting the children might want to take the long weekend coming up and going up to Idaho with us.
I got vetoed pretty fast, huh?
Well, with all their schoolwork and activities, that doesn't surprise me.
Suggesting something sudden like that, not like you.
Oh, I probably overreacted.
Oh, my God, Wes. After what happened to Susan, you can't be too careful.
Something's going on. We have a right to know.
I didn't mean to upset you.
I'm not concerned about us. Are those children safe?
I'm not going to endanger the children.
I'm sure that you didn't think you would endanger Susan either.
Carol.
She thought it was you. That is what happened. That is what made her do it.
But she knew better, Robin. That's the whole point. She knew better and she went down there anyway.
I don't want to hear this!
I don't think any of us are in the right frame of mind to discuss this.
Where are you going?
Out. Just out.
Kennedy, nobody can answer that question for somebody else.
The first time in my life, I really think I want to pack up and go.
Hey, that's because you're afraid for the kids.
I want to go. It's because I don't trust anyone else to take care of them or that I'm really scared.
Hey, we're scared every night we go out there.
That's a different kind of fear. That fear starts the juices flowing. It makes us smart.
Keeps you one step ahead.
This time it's jelly legs fear.
Well, maybe you've got the right instinct. Why don't you try a vacation?
Oh, great. So we take a vacation. Then what do? Come back, take another one? How long's that gonna go on?
That's it.
What?
La Rosa Negra. You want me to give you permission to smoke her?
A hell of a way for a cop to feel.
Yeah. Except we don't do it.
A lot easier being a vigilante than being a cop, huh? Look at Charles Bronson.
Or Sylvester Stallone. He wipes out armies all at once. Hey, bro, I'm sorry. I just haven't been too much help.
No. You put your finger on exactly what was bothering me. I mean, I want to be a vigilante, but I'm not running either.
Good. Sauna?
Great.
All right.
If you're here to talk vacation, you...
I run the DHD. Ortega made two reasonable requests to you. You gave your usual unreasonable reply.
Ed,
you're on light duty. No trips, nowhere without checking for me personally.
Any other choices?
Nothing's going down tonight anyway.
Is that official?
Street talking is kind of rumble. It's loud and clear.
Hey, Kennedy, look it!
Club. Check it out. She's drinking a beer. No ID. Nothing.
That's the end.
So we'll keep her overnight.
You can file for threatening an officer, Kennedy.
Without a witness?
Ortega.
He was in the car. He didn't hear any of it.
Yeah, but she's a gang member.
Come on, Stanley. It's not gonna wash.
Well, we got her off the streets. That's the whole idea, isn't it?
They're protecting a fellow officer, Kennedy.
Yeah, what's wrong with you, Wes?
I appreciate what you guys are trying to do. But it's not gonna solve anything.
First sensible thing I've heard you say, Kennedy. Look, there are about a dozen reasons why it's wiser to turn her loose. All her plans must be suspended while she's here. I'm aware of those plans, and it's better if they aren't suddenly changed, okay?
Including when she makes her move on Kennedy, right?
It's a matter of priorities.
Let her go.
Maybe something will be gained if you're the one to do it.
Someone needs to drive me home.
Captain Ortega has arranged that.
I have made my arrangement.
I've heard enough threats, Rosa.
Adios por ahora.
Morning, Frank. What happened?
Calls on the telephone. Whoever it is hangs up when I answer.
How many?
Three so far in the last 45 minutes. I've answered them all.
Anyone else know?
Well, I've tried to make a joke of it, but I'm not fooling anyone.
Thanks, Frank. I'll pay him less.
Morning.
Good morning.
Hi, Carol. Morning, sweetheart.
Morning, Daddy.
Kevin.
Sorry, everyone. Sorry.
Your grandfather told me that somebody's been playing games with our telephone.
Yes, and they're not very funny games.
Maybe one of us has a secret admirer.
Sounds like something one of your weird friends would pull.
My friends? Robin, you're the one who's been hanging around with all these space cadets.
Come on, you guys. Yesterday we had a discussion about going on a vacation. I'd like to get serious about that now, if it's okay with your grandparents.
I can make flight arrangements this morning.
Wait a minute. Don't we have anything to say?
Under the circumstances, I think you will do just what your father wants you to do.
Look, I'd rather just stay at a friend's house in the neighborhood.
Yeah, Grandma and Grandpa can protect us.
I don't know if even I can protect you. Honest, it's that serious.
Honey, I'll contact your teachers and get your assignments.
Oh, you're telling us to run away just because there's another nutcase on the streets.
There's always a nut on the streets.
It's exactly opposite of what you've always taught us.
Look, if we don't stand up to them, then the criminals are just going to rule the streets. Isn't that what you've always told us?
We shouldn't be chased out of our own home.
Right.
Hello. Who is this? Answer me. What's going on? Hello?
It's your turn, Kevin.
There. O. N. To
2 points.
What? You're not even trying.
I think I'll try a cassette.
Robin, how about a little soda?
One more sentence in this history report is finished. At least I won't flunk all my subjects.
Well, you'll do your work at our place. The teachers were very cooperative today.
Kevin, would you take that upstairs?
Okay, Pop, I will.
Maybe that'll keep you busy until it's time to go.
All right, Gramps, can you help me set this up?
Well, I'll give it a try.
No, I'd like to see a movie.
The plane leaves 10:30.
Well, there's plenty of time.
I want to set up my stereo, Robin.
I think it's better if you stay inside. Local cops will be by every few minutes, and they'll come to the door if anything looks strange.
Well, we could go to the movies near the airport.
Robin, you'll stay together until it's time to go.
We should leave for the airport about 9:30.
Even at the terminal, don't wander around. Get on the plane to Boise, and I'll call you in the morning, all right?
If you're alive.
Robin, that's a terrible thing to say.
Well, we're not the ones in danger. He is.
You should come with us, Pop.
If I go to work, everything will seem normal. Nothing will happen here. That's the most important thing to me.
I don't like being sent away.
Nobody likes it. It's what we have to do.
Okay, Pop. We heard you.
The both of you will be back in a few days. Let's not go away mad.
Sorry, Pop. I love you.
I love you too, kiddo.
Bye.
Bye.
I love you.
We'll take good care of them.
I know you will.
Wes, they love you so much. So do we.
Hold the doors!
What's going on, Sam?
Your gangs are having at it.
Where?
The old factory out on Concord. But you can't go down there.
It's open season on me wherever I go.
Both gangs inside.
Hard to figure. But the factory town boys made their move. Ortega was ready, so whatever's happening in there, we gotta contain.
What's with the blasting?
Seems all messed up.
Now, wait till we get in there.
You got a death wish.
I want Rosa to see that I'm down here in her territory, at least so my kids can get out of the city. Make sense?
Does to me.
We move in with a flare.
Put that gun down.
Hold it. Come on out. Come on. Put the little guns down. Come on. Move.
Move us.
Down. Come on. Come on. Move out. Come on. Easy. Easy. Move. Gun down.
This pipe bomb had a timer attached.
Looks like the factory town boys were suckered in by the 16th Street gang. They hit the place, but nobody was home.
Sounds like a scheme Rosa would come up with. Factory town gang loses face. She has more time to get ready.
Kennedy. Ortega, over here.
We have a tap on Rosa Santiago's telephone. She called your house this morning, right?
Yeah.
My wire man says she called again a few minutes ago. We have to do a number check.
You're not sure?
A woman answer. Your daughter?
What's going on?
Call your house. Get the details. I'll work on it from our side.
Come on.
We were in Kevin's room testing the stereo, but it was so loud none of us could hear the telephone.
Except for Robin. She was in the living room, and now she's gone.
For God's sakes, let me hear the tape.
I have your father. You want to see him alive, chica? You come alone to garage 1716 de Rios Avenue. I give you 1 hour.
Please, please, Wes, don't let her die. 1716 del Rios.
Thank you.
It's okay, babe. It's okay. It's okay.
Ooh. I am starved.
Well, I knew this was your favorite, right?
Doesn't that look delicious?
Another week before it's back to my specialty.
Well, you come to visit us this summer, and you'll have all kinds of good things like that.
I'm all for it. No offense, Pop.
Who says I'm not going to be there, too?
Well, you just got yourself a deal.
Okay, you got it.
Where's Robin?
I'll check.
Sorry I'm late.
Studying for finals?
Dad?
What? What is it, sweetheart? Tell me.
I still get scared.
So do I. It's only been 2 days.
But I always blamed you. And now I know better. I had to go down there just like Mom did. She had the same feelings. I have been so unfair to you. Daddy, I do love you. Love you so much.
The City returns next week at the later time of 11:35.